There are two shops, ABC and XYZ. We know that the price of a pen in shop ABC is 5 rupees, whereas XYZ shop sells 15 pens for just 60 rupees. Now you have to buy 8 pens. Where will you go? ABC shop or XYZ shop? Which would be the cheaper option for you? Let's look. What we know is that ABC shop sells it for 5 rupees, one pen. And we want to find the cost of 8 pens. So cost of 8 pens here would be nothing but, now this one pen costs 5 rupees. So 8 pens would be, you have to add 5 8 times. This is the price of one pen. For 8 pens you'll have to add 5 8 times. So this would be the cost of 8 pens. That is, you have to add 5 8 times. So when 5 is added 8 times, I can write repeated addition as multiplication. So this would be nothing but 8 times 5. That gives me rupees 40. So what I see is that 8 pens would cost me 40 rupees if I go to store ABC. Now there's another shop which is XYZ. There I know that 15 pens cost 60 rupees and I will see the price of 8 pens and then I can compare the price of 2. So first I need to find the price of 1 pen. I know cost of 15 pens is rupees 60. So how much would 1 pen cost me? Well, the 60 rupees have to be divided equally among 15 pens. Each pen would cost the same. So 60 is to be divided among 15 equally. That is, the price of one pen would be the total cost divided by 15. So price of one pen would be the cost of 15 units divided by 15, because you have to divide the cost equally among 15 units. So this gives me, we know the cost of 15 pens is rupees 60. And we have to divide it by 15. So 60 divided by 15 gives me 4. So 60 divided by 15, which gives me 4. So I get the price of one pen in the shop XYZ also. So XYZ, one pen, 4 rupees, but I wanted to find the cost of 8 pens. So 8 pens would be, again, one pen costs 4 rupees. So 8 would be, you have to add 4 8 times. So 4 added 8 times would be again repeated addition of 4. That is nothing but multiplication. So this would be equal to saying rupees 4 times 8. So this would be equal to 8 fours are 32, that is 32 rupees. So what I see is that in XYZ shop, 8 pens cost 32 rupees. So we know now the price of one pen in both the shops. ABC shop for 5 rupees and XYZ sells one pen for 4 rupees. So now you can see where you can go and buy the pens. Of course, clearly you can see that XYZ shop is selling the same pen at a lesser price. Again, knowing the cost of one pen, we actually found the cost of 8 pens. So we know that 8 pens in ABC shop would be nothing but 8 times 5, which is 40. So 40 rupees. We know the price of one pen at XYZ shop also, 4. We knew the price of 15 pens was 60. So we divided 16 by 15 and we got 4. So the price of one pen. And we could find from that price of 8 pens. So this is precisely what unitary method is. That is, if you know the price of one pen, you can find the total price by just multiplying the price of one with the number of units. So here, if you want to find the price of m units, you need to know the price of one unit and you multiply it by the number of units. Number of units here is m because you wanted to find the price of m units. So this is what unitary method is. That is, knowing the price of a unit, which is 1, you can find the total price. Similarly, what you can do is you can find the price of 1 unit also. Price of 1 unit would be nothing but total price of m units divided by number of units. So that is, price of 1 unit would be total price divided by number of units. So this is how you can use unitary method to find either the total price when you know the price of a unit, or you can find the price of 1 unit if you know the total price and the number of units which comprise that cost.